day our flagpole was ready, we had no flag to fly. A mother stepped forward and said, I have a flag, with a tear in her eye. It was given to me the day that we laid my son to rest. He was a true blue soldier who gave his life his best. I got a knot in my throat and a chill in my bones. A tear rolled down my face.
Northern California, came down here when I joined the Marine Corps. Spent 8 years on active duty. Brought my family out here today to support the family of a fallen Marine and give his life for our country. Most honorable thing you can do as a service member.
My wife read it on Facebook about the soldier that was killed in Afghanistan in a plane crash. So we decided we'd come down here and pay our respects to him. You know, well, they were fighting for us.
Christopher was my oldest brother, and he's the one that motivated me to join the Marine Corps, and he's the reason why I'm a poolie right now. And I'm going to ship in 2.5 weeks on October 26th. And a year ago, he brought me into the recruiting station because he believed in me. So that's why I'm out here, to support my brother.
How important was it for you to come out here and be part of this?
Extremely. My brother was one of a kind, I guess. It's still surreal. We found out last Friday, and he comes home today. So it's very important we're here to welcome him home.
When
we can share in a mother's eyes, you can see red, white, and blue. In a mother's eyes, you can see the pain so true. Freedom comes with a cause of sadness and of loss. You can see in a mother's eyes.
I helped assist the pain, tried to get a support group together and do whatever I could. Love Chris, love his family so much, and very grateful for the opportunity to be his neighbor and his friend, and proud that he served our country.
So, the response by the community, is it what you expected? Did it surprise you?
I'm very surprised. I'm very impressed from Temecula to Murrieta and Menifee, and we've all really come together, gotten a lot of response, you know, lots of support, so that's really awesome, and, what today is, really happy people are here to welcome him home and honor him for his service to our country.
And I heard about what happened to Chris. My wife's part of the members that are coming out here to honor him. And a Semper Fi to a brother Marine, and we're here to support him.
Everybody's coming to pay their respects today, so we thought we'd bring the kids out, and it's a great opportunity to teach them about paying respect to our fallen military. Okay. We thought we'd come out and show our respects.
Okay.
Yeah.
I mean, we actually want to stand up quietly and try to respect them.
Very good.
Yep.
And Zachary, how old are you?
13.
13. And who's your sister?
Emily's nine.
Okay, talk nice and loud. So, what are you going to do when the people come by?
We're going to stand up.
Speak up.
We're going
we're gonna stand up and we're gonna show respect for the soldier who passed away.
And how important is it to you to bring the children out here and to kind of teach them about this?
Yeah, we take every opportunity we can to teach them about, you know, these kinds of things and, you know, explain to them so that it's important to show respect and know exactly what's going on out there and why we need to show respect. So it's that's important to us. What they gave to me.
To you to have so many people come out here and pay tribute.
It means the world to us, as my cousin Rita said. You know, they touched all of our hearts, and the support has really lifted the family up and the friends. To see them just support Stella, his mom, and our cousin, his wife, Laurelyn, and our three little baby cousins, Brooklyn, Carter, and Aria. We live a little far from Menifee, so Menifee's like they're our second family for them, and you guys have really stepped up to the plate, and we're just very touched and honored and so very grateful to God for recognizing our cousin through all of these angels, I'll call them, that God has sent to keep us going.
How would you describe Chris as a person?
Chris. We can't just describe him in a few words. All of us say he's humble, you know, he'll make anybody laugh. He'll remind you what's real in life. He'll remind you that family is important, his country is important, and living every day to the fullest, like his wife Laurelyn said on the news channel ABC7. And he lived life to the fullest.
We'd like to also add that Christopher always let everyone know around him that he loved them, appreciated them, and was there for them. He always wanted to give back to the people, his family, and friends. Kept in touch with so many and always said he loved them before he left the conversation with them, because he felt that that's what he wanted.
You felt important around him. I remember Chris. I'm his, I'm Mexican, so I'm his aunt in Mexico, my cousin. And he just had a beautiful smile, beautiful eyes, and his smile just lit up any room that he walked into. The whole room would just light up.